Hello, parents, guardians, nannies, babysitters, grandparents, and whoever else I may be talking to right now. Alright, you have your kids for 2 weeks now. Your older kids may think this is a two-week vacation and they're pumped for all the video games they're about to play. Your younger kids may be excited about playing video games, but they also might be feeling a little bit anxious and confused as to why they can't go to school right now. Video games? Let's limit that, alright? So your teachers may be sending you some work to do throughout the weeks that you're home with them, with the kiddos, you know? It's hard for me to do that as a music teacher, so what I can do is I can send you a video with some creative ideas to keep the kids engaged, focused, and moving throughout these 2 weeks. Of course, most of these are music related as I am a music teacher, but I have included a few that aren't music related, so stay tuned. Alright, here we go. Number one. Suppose it's a cold and rainy day and you just don't feel like taking that family walk with your dog that you saw on the post on Twitter. It's a great idea, not on a rainy day. So what can you do to keep the kids moving? It's technology, but it's fun technology. It's Go Noodle. You can find it on YouTube. They have lots of videos that are great for young kids to keep them dancing, keep them singing, keep them moving. The people on these videos are super entertaining. My kids love them. Well, not my personal kids. I don't have personal kids. But yeah, have them watch a couple of these videos and it'll keep them moving and give them that exercise that they need for the day even though it's raining outside. Number two, channel your child's inner art and building skills by having them build an instrument or an invention out of recycled materials. Now, if you're one of the lucky ones, you got your stock of toilet paper at the store. Me, not so much, but I'm making it work. Anyways, you may have a bunch of toilet paper rolls that are empty now. Maybe you got newspapers, tissue boxes, things like that. Coffee cans, bottles, juice bottles, soda bottles. Give these materials to your kiddos and have them create an instrument or an invention. Once they've created their instrument, have them jam to some of their favorite songs with their newly built instrument. Or, if they're not feeling like jamming, have them create a music video. Have them plan out the music video, then have them create the video itself. With help from you, of course. If they decided to build an invention, help them plan a commercial to help sell their new product. You'll be surprised to see how creative your little friends can be. Number three, give students, or your kiddos in this case, some props and let them create their own music video to their favorite song. So, let's say on top of this new instrument they built, give them feather boas, hats, old dance costumes, whatever you can find in your attic or your basement or in your closet, and let them go wild and have them create a super awesome music video, alright? Get a collaboration going on with the siblings, with other family members in the house, include your dog if you want, you know? Get wild, alright? Number four, take a pop song or a folk song and change the words. So for example, if you take the song Row, Row, Row Your Boat, you can go ahead and make a super fun song. I have my students do a Dr. Seuss song out of that, and I get some really great results. So have them do that at home. They can do it with a pop song. I've done that with my fifth graders with bullying prevention. So do that. If you're feeling even more creative, create the whole song. New melody, new everything. Create a rap. I don't know. Go wild, all right? These 2 weeks at home are a good chance to teach some of the littles, teach some of the younger kids how to clean different parts of the house, not just cleaning up their toys, not just making their bed. Maybe they're learning how to clean the sink. Maybe they're learning how to sweep the floor. You know how you can make this fun? Blast some awesome music and take some breaks for a nice little dance party in between the sweeping. Number six. Dancing is an all-time high right now. There's so many dance crazes going on. So what I need you to do is to ask your kiddos to teach you some of the current dance trends that are going on. And then in return, you are going to teach some dance moves that you learned during your childhood and try to teach them it. All right? It could be really fun. It could be really silly. Just have fun with it, all right? Number seven, I'm doing a lot of collaboration activities that you can do with your kid or give them some time to do that by themselves or with their siblings. But here's something that they can do just by themselves. Just give them time to play with their toys. Alright? No electronics or anything like that. That was some of my best times, is when I got to play in my playroom. Actually, I would extend it to the whole house. The bus route for my dollhouse would be the entire downstairs, and other people would live in our cupboards. So my parents would often find toys in our cupboards, and I was like, well, you know, they're rusting. School starts tomorrow, you know? Or I've taken... Draw the music. What does that mean? It means give your kid a blank piece of paper, give him some colored pencils, some crayons, pencils, whatever you have easy access to. And using that blank piece of paper, that student is going to draw what they are hearing throughout the music. What's going on in that brain? Like, what are they seeing during the song? Draw the music. As soon as the music stops, they stop drawing. And then they start sharing with you the ideas that they had while they were listening to that music, all right? All right, you have some older kids, and I haven't provided many options for your older kids. Here's one that should be hopefully exciting to both you and the kid. A little bit of a challenge and a little bit of work. Here it is. It's called the Mini Research Project. I know, it already sounds boring, but just wait. You are probably hearing so much about this guy named Post Malone, this girl named Billie Eilish, you know, all these other people like that. Maybe you're tired of constantly hearing about it. But hey, that's what's around right now. So why don't you challenge your student to research an artist that you were obsessed with at the same age your child is now? And in return, your child is going to give you their current favorite artist for you to research and listen to. So you're going to look for things like you're going to listen to some of their music, you're going to figure out where they were born, you know, where they studied music, what was going on in their life, what instruments were they learning. These are the things that you want to be looking for through the research. Add an extra challenge and give them an artist that their grandparents enjoyed listening to when they were a kid. And hey, who knows? You might open doors for new genres of music that they may like to listen to now. Alright, I get it. You may need 10 minutes to yourself. Maybe it's to use the bathroom. Maybe it's to get dinner started. Maybe it's just you need 10 minutes of quiet time. I get it. I need it too. But you have a little learner who may not know how to read or may not read very well. And they can't be distracted by a book for 10 minutes. There's a great website called storylineonline.net where celebrities and other authors will actually read the books to your kids. So when you go to that website, you pick a book that your kid might want to listen to, you click on it, you click on the best way to watch it. I suggest YouTube, that's usually what I do, and it'll play the video for them, and they'll be distracted and listening to that story, giving you that minute to go do you for a minute, alright? Alright, here's some non-music ideas for you, alright? On that nice day outside, why don't you get a little crazy and create an obstacle course for your kids, have them involved in the creating process, then have your kid try the obstacle course, and for a challenge, why don't you try the obstacle course? And one of my personal favorites, well, not really. But competitions between siblings, parents, guardians, nannies, babysitters, whatever. Burpee competition. Who can do the most burpees? Who can do the most sit-ups? Who can do the most push-ups? Keep them active. Keep them moving, all right? Even though things seem pretty strange right now, it's important to have fun with your kids. Now, if you do any of these, I want you to share your photos and or videos to me on my Twitter page at HammerTime512. If you don't have a Twitter, you can send them to me at my email, lhammer@hopedaleschools.org. I look forward to seeing some of these creations and some of these fun things that you do with your kids during these 2 weeks. All right? Have a good 2 weeks, everyone, and we'll see you again soon.